East Lansing, Michigan at Spartan Stadium, the battleground for this college football encounter. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. Hayward from the two gets to about the 24-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. They go to the ground game. He makes his way to about the 32. Scott gains 8 yards on that play. It's second down, two to go. Ball on their own 32. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Off left side, tackle made at the 33.
They're going to come up short here on this third down. The defensive line did a great job of getting some penetration, and the overall defensive effort was big there to set up this fourth down.
Room around the corner. Harris fields it at the 27. They'll bring him down at the 38. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Goes around the 50-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
They'll bring him down around the 47-yard line. Gets to about the 34-yard line. He's tackled around the 31-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Scrambling around. Lost the ball. Fumble. Scoots it up.
That just shows you how determined this defense is. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. The stop right around the 30.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Second and 13. Ball on the 30.
Four down. Mike eight. Go! Watch this
before. And he's tackled at the 39. To punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Tackle made at the 28. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. And he's going to be sacked. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Picked off.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they push him out at the 27. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defense. But I think you're going to see both these offensive coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Under heavy pressure. Rolled, and that one's going to hit the ground. Incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. He's taken down around the 39-yard line. Hard at the 41-yard line.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Pearson, on play action. He gets hit out of bounds at the 34-yard line. And he has a huge gain.
Yeah, and I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
Slings it out there incomplete. From their own 34-yard line. Second down. At the 44. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Out in the open. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. He goes out of bounds at about the 41. This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He drops it. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
Well, at least for now, the crisis was averted, and they keep control of the ball.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. feeds it to the back. Nice run to the outside. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 37-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires to the wideout. First down. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line. From the 46-yard line. First down. Fires that quickly. Incomplete. To his receiver, and he's taken down around the 46-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, brought down at the 42-yard line. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. Little too much leg into that punt, they'll bring it out to the 20. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Fires incomplete. From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Gets out to about the 22-yard line. White is back deep to return the punt. And he's shoved out of bounds at midfield. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Tailback, and he's met in the backfield. From their own 47-yard line, second down. Gets it out, and he's met immediately. That's a loss of 4 yards.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go. Larry.
My game. Delivers to the halfback on the screen, and he is drilled at the 49. So at the end of one quarter, now this one's scoreless. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
From their own 17-yard line, it's second down. He airs it out. Brought down with only one man to beat. What happened there, Kirk?
Well, the defense came with a blitz, but the offensive line did a good job of holding the pressure off long enough for the quarterback to make a great throw.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Quick pass. Tackle made right around the 24-yard line. It's second and six. Ball on the 24. At the 24-yard line. Harris, back deep to return. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. He fights forward to about the 46. Can't get away from the pressure. White is back awaiting the punt. Down at the 22. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Nice run there as they work the outside. It's second down, five to go. Ball on their own 27. Makes it to the 37. Good open field tackle. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 39. And he just gets rid of it. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Harris is back to receive. He makes it to the 35-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. He's on the run. Slides down to the ground. Receiver incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Going deep. And they make the stop at the 21. Decent run up the gut. They'll bring him down right around the 16-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Complete big loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Central Michigan is looking to go up by three. It's up, and he's got it. They're ready for the kick. Hayward fields at the goal line. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Second down and 9 to go.
Ball on their own 25.
Just throws this one away. There's a strike complete. And he's tackled
at about the 25-yard line. I'd say that went about as well as the defense hoped it would.
You'd always like to move the ball at least past midfield, if only to win the field position battle. The defense wasn't going to give them anything on that drive.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. At this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Central Michigan holds a field goal lead. Here comes the pressure. He lets it go. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
From their own 36-yard line, second down. He's scrambling. Tackle around the 37-yard line. It all, and he's got the freshman. He's taken down right around the 20. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. Tries to buy some time, and they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Central Michigan's going to have to use their second time out of the half, and they'll look to convert here on another third down.
The Spartans running back left the game earlier with that injury, and now it's unlikely, they tell us, that he's going to be able to return today. Fires it out, and he tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. Central Michigan has a 3-point lead. It. He can't hang on. Incomplete. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Up the middle for a nice game. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. 3-0, Central Michigan.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. A tight, hard-hitting, low-scoring affair.
Great
This is right.
You can say it like it is.
This is right in your wheelhouse, Pollack. I mean, this is exactly in your comfort zone.
No, absolutely. I mean, you like to see people flying around. You like to see defenses dictating to offenses and make them play on our terms. And it's fun to watch. It's something that every great defense prides themselves on tackling. You know, you didn't see very many missed tackles in the first half that led to big plays. And try to limit those big plays. And when they do get down towards the red zone, make people kick field goals. And that's how you see dominant defenses year in and year out. And that's what we're seeing today.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26. For Michigan State, their pass rush has really been impressive today, Kirk. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him.
They also have that one takeaway.
This offense hasn't done a good job of moving the ball either.
That's one of the effects of not being able to protect the quarterback. He's having to get rid of it in a hurry to a checkdown to avoid a sack.
And for Central Michigan, they've been unable to connect on any long pass plays. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Central Michigan is up a field goal. And he's taken down at the 27.
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go. Mike 35.
He's going to try and scramble. He'll take it himself. Dives, and he's down.
Larry. 35's the mic.
I got it.
Quick strike to the receiver. Brought down around the 36-yard line. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Immediately tackled. Loss of about two.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
White will be the return man. Looking for the corner. Steps out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line, second down. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You don't want that.
Mike 8. Caught open field. Knocked out of bounds at
the 42.
That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
From the 42-yard line, first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. Made right around the 36-yard line.
Two tights.
Four down. My gate.
Go! 6-4.
Go!
Caught with room to work. He's out of bounds at the 28. It's first and 10. Ball on the 28. He fights forward to about the 26.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Come on, D.
My gate.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
I think sometimes offenses forget to even include corners as defenders and tacklers because a lot of corners just want to be out there and playing against the pass. But this is a corner that they have got to be responsible and remember in the future that he's got to be involved in being able to come up with a blocking scheme. This time they just let him go, and he's athletic and strong enough to come up and make a play.
And he brings it down. Touchdown, Michigan State. Tacks on the extra point. So a 9-play, 64-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill and not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
Harris from the 1, and he has it on the corner. And down he goes at the 27-yard line. Michigan State's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. And I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Quick strike, and he drops it. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
Three down. Mike 35.
Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. They go to the ground and he stops short. White back to return it. White fields it at the 42. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
The Spartans have got to remember that they've still got a fight on their hands in this football game.
Yeah, they cannot afford to get sloppy. Remember the first half, how bad they looked. And as good as things are going right now, with an entire quarter to go, they got to continue to play good football.
Michigan State is up four. They try the right side. And down he goes at the 33. First and 10. Ball on the 33. Gets out to around the 25.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
Four down. My gate.
Go! 28! Go!
He'll keep it on the ground again. What a play, and that is first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And they hit him in the backfield. That's a loss of about five.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 14-yard line. They'll bring him down around the 10-yard line. Michigan State is up by four. Bridges takes it up the middle, and they make the stop at about the 7-yard line. This one should be makeable. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20, across the 30, and he's tackled at the 35.
Brett, everywhere we go when we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread, or the pistol, and hurry up tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
Straight run, nothing going on there. Run, and he's brought down. And he's stopped behind the line.
The defense was playing the run all the way, and they got it right. Nice work.
White awaiting the return. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 16. Michigan State is up 7. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Mike 8.
it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's tackled
at about the 25-yard line.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Both offenses still trying to find a way to open things up. The end of three quarters. The Spartans with a touchdown lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Straight in the middle, and he meets the defense. From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. He's taken down at the 37-yard line. Michigan State is up a score. Tackle made at the 27.
It's been a good day for this defensive lineman, really showing off his skills.
Well, Brad, he really has, and he's doing a good job at taking advantage of getting lower than the offensive lineman. So he's got the leverage, and he's just driving those offensive linemen back into the backfield to disrupt the timing for this offense. And, you know, when you have the fundamentals and the technique that he has where he's wrapping up, he always seems to be in the perfect position, it's really no wonder that he has so many tackles.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame.
And that one's incomplete.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on their own 27. Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
At the 45-yard line.
Three down. 35's the mic.
Run down after a nice run up the middle.
Man left. Three down. Mike 35.
Quick release. Oh, had it knocked down. They'll line it up again on third down. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Incomplete.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter.
Michigan State up 7 points. And he just gets rid of it.
From their own 40-yard line, second down.
Watch out.
complete. Brought down, nothing doing. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. They'll bring him down at the 24. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Oh, and he can't hang on. Huge drop there. From their own 24-yard line. Second down. The ball, fumble. The offense scoops it. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He's at midfield, and they push him out around the 47-yard line.
Right and left, right and left. Two down, two down. Mike 35, Mike 35. Down. Hey, Texas. Check, check.
Russian, Russian.
Hey, Texas.
On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 50. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Third and long here. And for the defense, if they get a stop, they've got a great opportunity to help put this football game away. And here's a quick throw. It's picked off. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
Michigan State is up by a touchdown. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 36.
Mike 8. Mike 8.
And he shoved out of bounds right around the 48-yard line. Field. Tackle made at the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, first down.
Watch 14.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Strike to his receiver, no good. Brought down at about the 37-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26.
You're right. Great job here by the defender playing the ball, keeping his balance and getting in the way of that pass.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, if you like defensive football, you got to love this one.
Now, neither one of these offenses have gotten really into a rhythm the entire ball game. Still the fourth quarter to be played. It's anybody's game.
We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Got hit and still completed it. And he's taken down right around the 40. He's scrambling. And they got him. And it seemed like they had no problem getting to the quarterback on that play.
Great call by the defensive coordinator to call the blitz. It left the defensive lineman free to get to the quarterback.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Put down, Mike 35, Mike 35. Down.
They'll make the sack.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he's immediately tackled. Just under two to go in the game. White fields it at the 34, and down he goes at the 40.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're heading in the right direction.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Hayward gets about 4 yards on the play. From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. He's at the 40, at the 30, to the 20. And they tackle him at the 9-yard line. Central Michigan will have one timeout remaining. Down he goes, just outside the goal line. Central Michigan's out of timeouts. We've got second and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. A short yardage defense here. And they'll get him in the backfield.
SOS.
It's away from him. Touchdown. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Under a minute left.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Michigan State kicked this one off. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. Time's running short here, so let's see what plays out.
Well, now you've got to be thinking end zone on every play. You just don't have the time to do anything else.
Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening.
We're talking with the offensive coordinator this week. He told us that he has a lot of confidence in his quarterback to make good decisions. And when he feels like he has an opportunity to put the ball up, he knows the receivers that he can count on to be able to make big plays. That's another example. The receiver goes up in the traffic and makes a big play for a first down.
The spike will stop the clock.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46.
Three down. 35 to the right.
Set. Might have been some early movement up front. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Under heavy pressure. He's wrapped up for the sack.
So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six.
He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock.
Michigan State's team right now aware that they are a team. Hey, they're starting to shine today. Everybody else picked up the pace, though.
I think we all came in expecting to see that star player really shine. And the fact that they didn't have a great game from him and still won the football game, boy, I walk away from this game as a viewer just thinking even that much more about this team than maybe what I thought prior to the football game.